The words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be always acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus, our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. O come, let us adore him. O come. O be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Be assured to the Lord. He is God. It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. O go your way into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and speak good of his name. For the Lord is gracious, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures from generation to generation. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. O come, let us adore him. Be merciful to me, O God, for my adversaries are treading me down. They are daily fighting and troubling me. My enemies go about hounding me daily, for there are many who fight against me, O Most High. Nevertheless, though I am sometimes afraid, yet I put my trust in you, in God, whose word I trust. In God I trust and fear not. For what can flesh do to me? They daily distort my words. All that they imagine is to do me evil. They all gather together and lie in wait and mark my steps while they seek after my life. Shall they escape despite their wickedness? O God, in your displeasure cast them down. You record my lamentation, put my tears into your bottle. Are not these things noted in your book? Whenever I call upon you, then shall my enemies be put to flight. This I know, for God is on my side. In God, whose word I praise, in the Lord, whose word I praise, in God have I put my trust. I will not be afraid, for what can mortals do to me? Unto you, O God, will I pay my vows, unto you will I give thanks. For you have delivered my soul from death and from my feet from stumbling, that I may walk before God in the light of the living. Be merciful to me, O God. Be merciful to me, for my soul trusts in you, and under the shadow of your wings shall be my refuge until this tribulation has passed. I will call unto the Most High God, even unto the Lord, unto the God who shall fulfill his purpose for me. He shall send from heaven and save me. He shall confound those who trample on me. God shall send forth his mercy and truth. My soul is among lions that devour the people. Their teeth are spears and arrows, their tongue a sharp sword. Exalt yourself, O God, above the heavens. Let your glory be over all the world, all the earth. They have laid a snare, they have laid a net for my feet and brought down my soul. They dug a pit before me, but have fallen into the midst of it themselves. My heart is firmly fixed. My God, my heart is fixed. I will sing and give praise. Awake, my soul, awake, lute and harp. I myself will awake in the dawn. I will give thanks unto you, O Lord, among the peoples, and I will sing praises unto you among the nations. For the greatness of your mercy reaches unto the heavens, and your truth unto the clouds. Exalt yourself, O Lord, above the heavens. Let your glory be over all the earth. Do you indeed decree righteousness, O you rulers? And do you judge uprightly, O children of men? No, you devise evil in your heart, and on the earth your hands deal out violence. The ungodly err even from their mother's womb. As soon as they are born, they go astray and speak lies. They are as venomous as the poison of a serpent, even like the deaf adder that stops its ears, which refuses to hear the voice of the charmer, no matter how skillful his charming. Break their teeth, O God, in their mouths. Smite the jawbones of the ungodly. Let them fall away like water that runs off. Let them wither like the grass that is trodden underfoot. Let them melt away like a snail and be like a stillborn child that does not see the sun before they bear fruit. Let them be cut off like a briar. Let them be like thorns and weeds that are swept away. The righteous shall rejoice when they see the vengeance. They shall wash their feet in the blood of the ungodly, so that people shall say, truly there is a reward for the righteous. Surely there is a God who judges the earth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the first book of Samuel, beginning with the second chapter, the first verse. Then Hannah prayed and said, my heart rejoices in the Lord. My horn is exalted in the Lord. My mouth speaks boldly against my enemies because I rejoice in your salvation. There is no one holy like the Lord. Indeed, there is no one besides you, nor is there any rock like our God. Do not go on boasting so very proudly. Do not let arrogance come out of your mouth, for the Lord is a God of knowledge, and with him actions are weighed. The bows of the mighty are broken to pieces, but those who have stumbled strap on strength. Those who were full hire themselves out for bread, but those who were hungry cease to be hungry. Even the infertile woman gives birth to seven, but she who has many children languishes. The Lord puts to death and makes alive. He brings down to Sheol and brings up. The Lord makes poor and rich. He humbles. He also exalts. He raises the poor from the dust. He lifts the needy from the garbage heap to seat them with nobles. and he gives them a seat of honor as an inheritance from the pillars of the earth are the Lord's. For the pillars of the earth are the Lord's, and he set the world on them. He watches over the feet of his godly ones, but the wicked ones are silenced in darkness. For not by might shall oppressed prevail. Those who contend with the Lord will be terrified. Against them he will thunder in the heavens. The Lord will judge the ends of the earth, and he will give strength to his king and will exalt the horns of his anointed. Then Elkanah went to his home at Ramah, but the boy continued to attend to the service of the Lord before Eli the priest. Now the sons of Eli were useless men. They did not know the Lord, and this was the custom of the priests with the people. When anyone was offering a sacrifice, the priest's servants would come while the meat was cooking with a three-pronged fork in his hand, and he would thrust it into the pan or kettle or cauldron or pot. Everything that the fork brought up, the priest would take for himself. They did so in Shiloh to all the Israelites who came there. Also, before they burned the fat, the priest's servants would come and say to the man who was sacrificing, "Give the priest meat for roasting, as he will not take cooked meat from you, only raw." And if the man said to him, "They must burn the fat first, then take as much as you desire," then he would say, "No, but you must give it to me now, and if not, I am taking it by force." And so the sin of the young men was very great before the Lord, for the men treated the offering of the Lord disrespectfully. Now Samuel was ministering before the Lord as a boy, wearing a linen ephod, and his mother would make for him a little robe and bring it up to him from year to year, while she would come up with her husband to offer the yearly sacrifice. Then Eli would bless Elkanah and his wife and say, "May the Lord give you children from this woman in place of the one she requested for the Lord, of the Lord." And they went to their own home. The Lord indeed visited Hannah, and she conceived and gave birth to three sons and two daughters. And the boy Samuel grew up before the Lord. Now Eli was very old, and he heard about everything that his sons were doing in all Israel, and that they slept with the women who served at the doorway of the tent of meeting. So he said to them, "Why are you doing such things as these, the evil things that I hear from all these people? No, my sons, for the report is not good which I hear the Lord's people circulating. If one person sins against another, God will mediate for him. But if a person sins against the Lord, who can intercede for him?" But they would not listen to the voice of their father, for the Lord desired to put them to death. Now the boy Samuel was continuing to grow and to be in favor both with the Lord and with people. Then a man of God came to Eli and said to him, "This is what the Lord says. Did I not indeed reveal myself to the house of your father when they were in Egypt in bondage to Pharaoh's house? Did I not choose them from all the tribes of Israel to be my priests, to go up to my altar, to burn incense, to carry an ephod before me? And did I not give to the house of your father all the fire offerings of the sons of Israel? Why are you showing contempt for my sacrifice and my offering, which I have commanded for my dwelling? And why are you honoring your sons above me by making yourselves fat with the choices of every offering of my people, Israel? Therefore the Lord God of Israel declares, I did indeed say that your house and the house of your father was to walk before me forever. But now the Lord declares, far be it from me. For those who honor me, I will honor, and those who despise me, I will be insignificant. Behold, the days are coming when I will eliminate your strength and the strength of your father's house, so that there will not be an old man in your house. And you will look at the distress of my dwelling, in spite of all the good that I do for Israel, and there will never be an old man in your house. Yet I will not cut off every man of yours from my altar, so that your eyes will fall, so that your eyes will fail from weeping and your soul grieve, and all the increase of your house will die in the prime of life. And this will be the sign to you which will come in regard to your two sons, Hophni and Phinehas. On the same day, both of them will die. But I will raise up for myself a faithful priest who will do according to what is in my heart and my soul. And I will build him an enduring house, and he will walk before my anointed always. And everyone who is left in your house will come to bow down to him for a silver coin or a loaf of bread and say, please assign me to one of the priest's office so that I may eat a piece of bread. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to you, Lord God of our fathers. You are worthy of praise. Glory to you. Glory to you for the radiance of your holy name. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you in the splendor of your temple, on the throne of your majesty. Glory to you. Glory to you seated between the cherubim. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you beholding the depths and the high vault of heaven. Glory to you. Glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. A reading from St. Paul's first epistle to the Corinthians, beginning with the 11th chapter, the first verse. Be imitators of me, just as I also am of Christ. Now I praise you because you remember me in everything and hold firmly to the traditions, just as I handed them down to you. But I want you to understand that Christ is the head of every man, and a man is the head of a woman, and God is the head of Christ. Every man who has something on his head while praying or prophesying disgraces his head, but every woman who has her head uncovered while praying or prophesying disgraces her head, for it is one and the same as the woman whose head is shaved. For if a woman does not cover her head, have her also cut her hair off. However, if it is disgraceful for a woman to have her hair cut off or her head shaved, have her cover her head, for a man should not have his head covered, since he is the image and glory of God, but the woman is the glory of man. for man does not originate from woman, but woman from man. For indeed, man was not created for the woman's sake, but woman for the man's sake. Therefore, the woman should have a symbol of authority on her head because of the angels. However, in the Lord, neither is man independent of, neither is woman independent of man, nor is man independent of woman. For as the woman originated from the man, so also the man has his birth through the woman, and all things originate from God. Judge for yourselves, is it proper for a woman to pray to God with her head uncovered? Does even nature itself not teach you that if a man has long hair, it is a dishonor to him? But if a woman has long hair, it is a glory to her, for her hair is given to her as a covering. But if anyone is inclined to be contentious, we have no such practice, nor have the churches of God. Now, in giving this next instruction, I do not praise you, because you come together not for the better, but for the worst. For the worse. For in the first place, when you come together as a church, I hear that divisions exist among you, and in part I believe it. For there also have to be factions among you, so that those who are approved may become evident among you. Therefore, when you come together, it is not to eat the Lord's Supper. For when you eat, each one takes his own supper first, and one goes hungry while another gets drunk. What? Do you not have houses in which to eat and drink? Or do you despise the church of God and shame those who have nothing? What am I to say to you? Shall I praise you? In this I do not praise you. For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he also took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Therefore, whoever eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy way shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But a person must examine himself, and in so doing, he is to eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For the one who eats and drinks judgment to himself if he does not properly recognize the body. For this reason, many among you are weak and sick, and a number are asleep. But if we judge ourselves rightly, we would not be judged. But when we are judged, we are disciplined by the Lord, so that we will not be condemned along with the world. So then, my brothers and sisters, when you come together to eat, wait for one another. If anyone is hungry, have him eat at home, so that you do not come together for judgment. As to the remaining matters, I will give instructions when I come. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Splendor and honor and kingly power are yours by right, O Lord our God. For you created everything that is, and by your will they were created and have their being. for yours by right, O Lord, thou wast slain, for with your blood you have redeemed for God from every family, language, people, and nation, a kingdom of priests to serve our God. And so to him who sits upon the throne, and to Christ the Lamb, be worship and praise, dominion and splendor, forever and forevermore. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us, and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us, and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness, and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, the Spirit to think and do always those things that are right, that we, who can do no good thing apart from you, may by you be enabled to live according to your will, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you is eternal life, and to serve you is perfect freedom. Defend us, your humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in your defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, who alone works great marvels, send down upon our clergy and the congregations committed to their charge the life-giving spirit of your grace, shower them with the continual dew of your blessing, and ignite in them a zealous love of your gospel, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory glory to God, who's working, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than what we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation in the church and in Christ Jesus forever and ever. Amen.